This is your brain. This is your brain on drugs. Any questions?
I've been thinking, here, I want to keep this somewhat short because no one else could play me better than me. I was one of those kids, I peed in my pants so I was like 6. This is my bong. Wow, is the government for real? Paid my teacher, my doctor, and probably my parents. I had to be stripped naked, butt searched. It was scary, and it should be scary to anyone. And so I've had experiences like that my whole life. Do I really have to listen to them? And that's why the Bible says the love of money is the root of evil. It's good, that's right. Hey guys, I pray this is a good lesson for you and you enjoy what I'm about to teach. I've been having these deep thoughts about my own life, and I think about everybody's life. We all feel like we're the star of our own movie, and we are. And the Bible is real, and what it is, it's the story of a family, that these are stories were passed down and kept. And as a kid, I think I mentioned this once before, I felt like this was my family, and I still feel that way. And I've been really fortunate enough to have these strange experiences.
Do you ever use these drugs purely for pleasure? It's hard to answer that question because a religious revelation or a scientific discovery is a pleasurable event. These drugs also enhance and amplify all sorts of awareness. When I want to escape from the problems of the world, I take a drink or two. Marijuana and LSD are consciousness magnifying drugs. If I want to get in closer contact with reality, I would smoke marijuana or take LSD.
Got to hang out with Timothy Leary as a teenage, Harry Nielsen, and I met Ringo Starr and I met other celebrities, but these are people I actually got to hang out with. And one night I was spending the night at my friend's house. So I woke up in the morning, I used the restroom, and Bob Dylan is sitting in my friend's kitchen, and he's wearing a shirt kind of unbuttoned, drinking a Coors beer at 7 in the morning, and reading Hitler's Mein Kampf, like a yellow and orange copy. And I said good morning to him, and he was like, hey, good morning. And I thought, oh my God, this is nothing like my dad. And I said, why are you reading Mein Kampf? Like, why not? I said, oh, it's a good answer. And so I've had experiences like that my whole life that other people somewhat find interesting. And I find interesting too that I met celebrities and had this interesting stuff touch my life, including the guy who was like, this is your brain. This is your brain on drugs. And like, dude, that was my drug dealer. I used to buy weed from him. And it's funny because it's the same technique they're using. When the marijuana was illegal, they were making us out to be domestic terrorists. If you buy marijuana, you're supporting the murder of drug judges in Colombia. You killed me, and they show these kids coming back in their propaganda.
That seems to be where this PSA came from, and why it stops just short of calling potheads terrorists.
It's the money.
The connection to terrorist organizations here is likely overestimated.
What do I have to do with this?
They were drug dealers fighting about money.
Just always been in the epicenter for some reason. You know, that's why I'm in probably in all these movies. I'm in 15 movies about marijuana. I was on the TV show Weeds, where only Snoop Dogg and myself play ourselves on the show. Anyway, I feel like I've been under surveillance since I was 5 years old. When I was 5 or 6 years old in the first grade, my teachers in Northern California got me in a long-term study on attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. It was a new disorder they were creating at the time, so they could sell drugs to kids. Plenty of adults were using pharmaceuticals. I think the Rolling Stones had a song out called Mother's Little Helper about Valium from the Valerian root. Valium is a drug. And so that's what happens. These pharmaceutical companies went and captured all of the roots and plants and drugs, and they synthesized them and patented them and sold them back to you. And that's really what's going on. And we have to separate ourselves from the system that's separating us from nature. We have to live a more natural life, because that's a more spiritual life. And the corporations guided the people onto the cities because that's where they needed them to work. And now what they want to do is eliminate the people. And whether it's driving them away from the cities, like they're doing to me personally.
100,000 people left LA over the last decade for various reasons you could probably make an educated guess about.
We're killing them. I think the pharmaceutical companies are okay with either way as long as they're making money. And that's why I have a concern that we are at war, that I may be killed for my ideas and my thoughts. And I don't want that to happen. I'm okay with that happening, knowing that Jesus got my back and he ain't gonna let anything happen to me that wasn't meant to happen. So I'm here doing my thing. I came unafraid enough to speak out, share my story. so you guys can get the message.
Ezekiel 25:17, the path of the righteous man is beset on all sides by the iniquities of the selfish and the terrible. Blessed is he who in the name of charity and goodwill shepherds the weak through the valley of darkness, for he is truly his brother's keeper and the finder of lost children. And I will strike down upon thee with great vengeance and furious anger those who attempt to poison and destroy my brother. And you will know my name is the Lord when I lay my vengeance upon thee.
And move on, because you got lives to lead. And that's the whole point, is we have to separate ourselves. The solution to this new world order, to the globalist authoritarian system, that the global reset that we see cracking down on us and destroying our lives, ruining our jobs.
The United States had won the Cold War. The idea was that all countries would embrace democracy. Internet would spread information and undermine dictatorships. These dreams have not come true. China has become a dominant power. The Arab Spring failed, and countries like Russia and Turkey have moved away from democracy. And even in the West, a free media can no longer be taken for granted, and independent judiciaries are also under pressure. And while internet did increase people's access to information, it has come with fake news and massive digital surveillance. Many people are worried about authoritarianism. Political scientists can help us understand what authoritarianism is and how it might relate to other tendencies such as populism or xenophobia.
Trying to ruin our jobs. Closing businesses is weak, and that's why they have to threaten. You have to get the mandate, you have to get the mandate. In the book of Revelation, it says it's coming. But you who are listening to me, who believe the Bible, don't have to be unprepared. That's the whole point. That's why we're promoting Shiba Inu, XRP, Bitcoin, and other cryptocurrencies. That's why we accept donations in cryptocurrencies. One of the things that I said that was kind of controversial was I said I've been under surveillance since I was a young person. The drug companies put me into a long-term study. They came to my school and to my doctor. I was positively identified as hyperactive and attention deficit disorder.
And then if it looks like it's going to work out, then it'll go up to the higher level to a pharmaceutical company.
I was put in a control group of the people who were not given any drugs. My parents were against drugs. My dad doesn't even like taking aspirin, doesn't drink any alcohol. So I got put into this long-term study, and they paid my teacher, my doctor, and probably my parents to positively identify, oh yeah, he's a hyperactive kid. I matched all their criteria of speaking out in class, interrupting, whatever. Whatever the criteria was, I matched it. Twice a year, I was interviewed and questioned by people from UC Berkeley in a study financed by the drug companies for their psychological department. After that, I was then surveilled in college. The LAPD had a undercover officer who was my girlfriend for over a year, and that was really disappointing, kind of sad. Took away time from my life when I could have been meeting someone who was sincere about having a relationship with me. Instead, I'm having a relationship with an LAPD undercover officer who eventually never arrested me or busted me for anything after a year of surveillance. But she did end up killing my grandmother because she stole my marijuana that I was using as medicine to keep my grandmother alive. And as soon as she stole it, my grandmother was dead within 30 days. I write about that in my book, 9021 Grow. And I've written a book called Domestic Terrorist, because as the commercial says, for marijuana smoking, they were calling you a domestic terrorist. And at some point, you have to realize, wow, is the government for real? Do I really have to listen to them? Or do I stand up and have faith in God and His word and know that these people are using brainwashing, sorcery, pharmakia to try and control the population? They're sick, they're evil. They need to be punished. They made people die during this pandemic. The point I'm trying to make is we've got a corrupt society, and instead of fighting, they want us to fight and have a civil war. So these are the kind of hypocrites. They're working for China. They're trying to kill you. They're working for the globalist regime, and they're trying to kill you. They don't care anything about you. They shoved your grandparents into nursing homes with flu-positive people, with COVID-positive people. They don't care about you. I want you guys to have the positive message. God loves you. I love you. Temple 420. 20 love you. Buy one of our NFTs and don't lose hope. We just have to get the fuck out of their system right now.